And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot comprehend it. There is a need for light in the midst of the prevailing darkness on the earth today that will shatter the power of darkness. And that light is the Word of the Living God. The vessel of the Living God, Bishop Abiola Idowu, brings you the light.
A new song coming to you. A new song.
Through the Word of God that will bring you to total fulfillment in life. No more sickness, disease, failure, guilt, condemnation, and affliction in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, welcome Bishop Abiola Idowu.
Praise the Lord. I'm so excited to be with you tonight on the dominion over sickness and disease. I'm so excited because I know the provision of God for every one of us is to live an healthy life. Let me tell you this, God loves you and He wants you to live an healthy life. Sickness and disease is not part of His plan for your life. You need to rise up to that and understand His eternal purpose so that you can enjoy His inheritance for you. So today, I want you to just open your spirit and receive the word of God that will change your life forever. Before we go into the word tonight, let's have a word of prayer. Father, we thank you so much in the name of Jesus, the name that is above every other name. We thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you for the anointing of God over your word. Thank you for your spirit. Thank you for your strength. Lord, receive all our praise in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking, oh God, that you will anoint this tongue, that I will speak the word of God like the oracle of the living God, that the power of God will break every sickness and every disease and every affliction that is in the life of God's people. Lord, you will prove that Jesus is alive in the life of everyone today. And we vow we'll return all the glory and all the praise to you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I want to welcome you one more time to this program. I want to thank God for everyone watching us on any platform you are watching from. You are welcome in Jesus' mighty name. Now listen to this very carefully. The purpose of a thing determines the result. The purpose of a thing determines the creation of that thing and the result that it produces. Now, the Bible says in 1 John chapter 3, verse 8, let's look into it. It said, he that committed sin is of the devil, for the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. Come on, I have a good news for you. The works of the devil is destroyed today in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now you will discover that we from the scripture, we saw the purpose of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says he came to destroy the works of the devil. Now look at this. Now, when Job was sick, we knew from the word of God that the devil smote Job. We saw in chapter 13 and verse 16, the Bible says that woman was bound by the devil, by Satan, for 18 years. For 18 years, he was bound by the devil. So the Bible says the Son of God manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. What amazes me is the devil knows his limitations, but the saints don't know their position. The devil knows his limitations, but the saints don't know their position. So, and if you don't know your position, you'll be robbed of your inheritance. And that is what the enemy is doing. Or what the devil wants to do is to show you what God has not spoken. And it will prove everything, with you logically, scientifically, and begin to torment the mind of the people until they begin to repudiate the word of God and they don't agree with God's word. They don't know that the Son of God didn't come for Christmas, for Easter. They don't know that Jesus Christ don't come to make them religious, but he came to destroy the works of the devil. And if it is true that the Jesus Christ came, if it is true that he died and he rose from the dead, then the devil don't have no right to touch any child of God. Now, but if he can convince you to repudiate the word of God, to deny that the word is true, you already giving him an open check to do whatever he wants to do in your life. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 13, in verse 13, he said, whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. So people are destroyed not because the devil is stronger than them, but because they despise the word of God. God has a comprehensive plan for our health. He's so clear in the covenant. When he called Israel out, he made them to know, I am God and I love you so much, and part of my redemptive program for you is sound health. I didn't want any one of you to have cancer. I didn't want any one of you to have diabetes. I didn't want any one of you to die young. It's not in my program. In fact, he told them by covenant. He said in Exodus chapter 15, and verse number 26, he said, and said, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and will do that which is right in his sight, and give ear to his commandment, and keep his statutes, he said, I will put none of the diseases upon thee which I have brought upon the Egyptians, for I am the Lord that healeth thee. Oh my God, that is strong. I am the Lord that healed thee. I want you healed. I want you whole. That was exactly what Jesus Christ was telling the people when he came here. He would tell them, I will be thou healed. That man, that leper came and he said, I mean, Jesus Christ, if you will, that can make me clean. Jesus Christ said, I will. He's still telling you in that situation, maybe you have blindness, paralysis, maybe cancer, maybe diabetes. It doesn't matter what it is. Jesus Christ is standing beside you. Remember, he said, I will never, ever leave you nor forsake you. He set you there. It already ratified in heaven that in your bedroom, in your living room, wherever you are, there is an invisible guest beside you standing too close than the clothes you put on. His name is Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. He said, I won't leave you nor forsake you, and I will be thou clean. And however, people don't receive the fullness of God's divine provision for their health because they be lied to. The enemy clog their healing with different lies. Number one lie that I've seen that he has a lie to people, and people bought into those lies is, God is not speaking to me. I know the word of God is true, but God, I don't think God is speaking to me. Now listen to this. God is speaking to you. Now, if you don't believe that the word of God is for you, I'm telling you, the devil will rob you. I know a lot of people just say, I know you spoke to the blind man. I know he spoke to the demonic man in Gadara. I know he healed the paralytic man in Capernaum. But to me now that I'm in so place, maybe I'm in Africa or in Germany or Europe or I'm in Africa, I don't think he's speaking to me. Now let me tell you this. The word of the Lord is life. He said, what I say to one, I say to all. Now, he's speaking to you that, in fact, the scripture is written with you in mind. Behind every scripture is your name. Let me give you an example. If you want to believe that he's not speaking to you directly, now, why do you believe that he spoke about your redemption? 2,000 years ago, you are not there. Over 2,000 years ago, you are not there, and Jesus Christ died for your sin, and you believe that he died for your sin. You gave your life to him. Now, how dare you now doubt that he's speaking to you when he said, I will be thou clean. In fact, maybe you need to have an understanding that each time you see anything happen in the scripture, you are just behind that person, that if you are in the same shoe, God will have done the same thing for you. Just as he healed 2,000 years ago, he's still healing today, and you are in the center of his plan. So whenever the enemy tells you, well, when God is just saying, go and be healed, no, you are free. Maybe he's not talking to me. He's talking to you. Just put your name there and receive it. Number two thing that the enemy is telling everybody is, I am not qualified for this healing. I don't think I'm qualified. And he just put a lot of guilt and condemnation in people's mind. Let me tell you this. He's a lie from the pit of hell. Now, God is not teaching you anything with sickness and disease. He doesn't have one. So he can't give it. And you can only give what you have. I want you to listen to this very carefully. If God is going to heal you based upon your perfection, you will die in sickness. So God is not going, is not even doing that at all. The Bible says, if I regard iniquity in my heart, God will not listen to me. But listen to this. He said, if God will mark iniquity, nobody will stand. He made you righteous so that he can reach out to you. He said, as the east is far to the west, he said, God has removed our iniquity away from us. He did that so that he can reach out to us and just bless us with his healing power. Let me tell you this. Each time you are healed, you show forth the glory of God. The enemy don't glorify God. So even when you discover that you have messed up, just repent immediately. Don't allow the enemy to use your sin to torment you, because God is not excited that you are under the siege of the wicked one. He's not excited that you are sick and you are oppressed. No, repent, and the blood of Jesus cleanses you from all your sins and your iniquities. And right there, you become the righteousness of God that is upon your life begin to manifest. Don't let the devil be in a place whereby he's the one putting you in condemnation. That is not God's will. That is not God's plan. And don't ever agree with it. Another lie that the enemy uses is that I caused this situation, so God won't heal me until I pay the price for my punishment. No. That is not how God operates. Now, let me show you this. Jesus Christ was speaking in Matthew chapter 9, verse 12 to 13. The Bible says, but when Jesus heard that, he said unto them, they that behold me not a physician, but they that are sick, but ye go and learn what that meaneth. I have mercy and not sacrifice, for I have come to call right. I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. So I know this situation, I caused it, and I know God will make me to pay for it before he heals me. No, Jesus Christ said it here. I didn't even come for the righteous. I come for the sinners. I want to save them. When God said he want to save you, he's not going to put a burden on you to save you. He's going to rescue you from that thing. So each time the devil is telling you that, tell the devil, my sins have been forgiven, and Jesus Christ already took it out of my record. In fact, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19 to 20, he said to me that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and had committed unto us the word of reconciliation. He's not putting it into your account. So as far as God is concerned, there is nothing in your account that warrants sickness and disease. Now, if God said you are righteous, if God said he didn't have anything against you, why should you put anything against yourself? I'd like you to shake it off right now. It's time for your healing. The purpose of Jesus for coming is to set you free, is to liberate you, is to establish you, is to bring glory back into your life. I'd like you to be angry. If this price is paid, I am not supposed to be in this situation anymore. I'm not supposed to carry pain. I'm not supposed to carry disease and infection. I'm not supposed to be down. I'm supposed to fly far above in the mighty name of Jesus. With that mindset, I'd like you to release your faith as we pray, because this affliction is going to drop off you right now. This situation is going to change in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, I stand by the authority of your name, the power of your word, and I rebuke every sickness. I come against every disease in the body of God's people. Lord Jesus, when you saw that woman that was bound by the devil, you took everything that the enemy planted into that body out, because that is the purpose you came. Lord, these people believe your word. In their system, everything that is called pain, everything that is called affliction, everything that is called cancer, every leukemia, every blindness and paralysis, hear the word of the living God. By the name of Jesus Christ that died and rose from the dead, I come against you and I command you to get out in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive now your total freedom. Receive now your total healing. Receive now your total deliverance. I decree over that leg, over that limb that is giving you pain. I speak against every pain in your body, arthritis. Go, come back no more in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. To you be glory and praise forever. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You know what just happened to you right now? You are healed. You are healed. Begin to exercise your faith by taking steps. Say it to yourself. Jesus Christ loves me so much. I refuse this sickness in Jesus' name. Now that you are healed, remember, God don't want you to be in a place whereby you are healed and the enemy is still coming back and putting oppression into your body. And that is why it's very important for you to come into the family where sickness and disease is not allowed. And that is what Jesus can make available to every one of us when we give our life to him. I want to encourage you this night. Say yes to Jesus. Say yes from your heart. If you are ready to do that, why don't you just pray this prayer together with me? Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you thanks because you love me. You died for me. On the third day, you resurrected. From today, I give my life to you. Jesus, come into my heart. Live your life through me. From today, I'm born again. I'm a child of God. Thank you for saving me in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. The good news is you are now a child of God. The next step is to find out what is expected of me as a child in the kingdom, what I need to learn. And that's why I'm inviting you to join us in the fellowship. Either you're joining online or you're coming to meet us in the church on Sunday. Don't miss it. Tomorrow night is another opportunity. We are having a study of the word. Come join. Listen to the word of God. Let the word of God just change your life. Somebody was telling me, he said, it was like a body was lifted off my head when I was in the meeting. Now, God wants to lift your burden. He wants to change your story. Join us tomorrow. Join us on Sunday, and your life will never remain the same again. Till I see you next time, stay blessed, and remember, Jesus is alive.